The Christchurch City Mission is concerned an increase in beggars could mean those who genuinely need help won't get it. More people are begging than live on the streets, and those who are really homeless say it's giving them a bad name. Jess Cartwright reports.
Begging, it's becoming a common sight in the heart of Christchurch. But City Missioner Matthew Mark says some are taking advantage of those who are genuinely homeless.
Anecdotally, I can probably sort of say we're about 85-90% of those who are begging, we have an awareness that they actually have a roof over their head.
Since the Christchurch earthquake, homelessness has skyrocketed. A recent street count found more than 170 men and over 40 women are living on the streets. But even more are begging.
So I guess it's about, you know, making people aware that those two things, while they might seem that they are related, aren't necessarily the same.
The issue with beggars escalated last week, where one disrupted the city tram line and verbally abused a driver when asked to move.
Often they can become quite aggressive, and some of the business owners are, you know, they get quite concerned about it. It's interfering with their business.
The attentions brought scrutiny to the homeless community, many feeling they now have to prove they're in need.
I haven't had a home since the earthquake.
You only really find out who the real homeless people are if you go through the abandoned buildings or if you go down the streets at like 3 in the morning.
The City Council are working on a Housing First initiative to fight the problem.
I really am focused on trying to get those people who are in and out of houses the proper support so they do stay off the streets when they get a house.
The initiative is currently awaiting approval from central government. Jess Cartwright, One News.